Now, the classification of elements into the blocks. This division is purely based on the differentiating electron. That electron enters either s orbital or p orbital or d orbital or f orbital of the element. So, depends upon the orbital which occupies by the differentiating electron. These elements are classified into four blocks. The first one is s block elements. The s block elements indicates that the differentiating electron or the last electron of the element is entering in s orbital. That means in generally we know that s orbital has a capability to occupy the two electrons. So s orbitals or s block elements can form the two groups. One group from S1 configuration and another group from S2 configuration. So it forms the two groups. You can see the periodic table in the left hand side, two groups which are first one comes under S1 category, that is group 1, usually called it as alkali metals. And the next electron which is enters in the same block, that is S2, that usually called it as group 2 elements. General name for those elements are alkaline earth metals. Now, coming to the periodic table, you can see in this periodic table, left portion of the periodic table is occupied by the S block elements, that is first group and second group, alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. Now, coming to the periodic table, you can see in this periodic table, left portion of the periodic table is occupied by the S block elements, that is first group and second group, alkali metals and alkaline earth metals. Coming to the first group, that is group 1, alkali metals. Here hydrogen, lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium and francium. We already discussed about the position of hydrogen. Even though it has a S1 configuration, it does not come under the either S block or it does not come under the halogens also. We have discussed already in the previous classes. Now coming to the lithium. The electronic configuration of the lithium is 1s2 2s1 because it has a atomic number equal to 3. So these 3 electrons are occupied into 1s1 orbital and 2s orbital. Coming to the sodium. Sodium 1s2 2s2 2p6 and 3s1 and potassium 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3p6 4s1 and rubidium, all are occupied same as in the potassium, and here on this some d electrons also is occupied. The final orbital which enters the differentiating electron is 5s1. For cesium this is 6s1. For francium this is 7s1. Or you can write like this, like argon which gives the electronic configuration up to 18 electrons. This is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6. Up to this is covered with argon only. Remaining is here for argon. For rubidium you can use krypton. For cesium you can use xenon. For francium, radon. Because the krypton has a atomic number 36 and rubidium is 37. The next electron or differentiating electron enters into 5s1 orbital. For xenon, atomic number is 54. For cesium, it is 55. So that next differentiating electron enters into 6s. For francium, it is 7s. So if you observe the all differentiating electrons of the group 1 elements, all are entered into S1 orbitals only. That means from this you can easily say the outermost electronic configuration of the group 1 elements is NS1. For lithium this is 2S1, for sodium 3S1, for potassium 4S1, for rubidium 5S1, cesium 6S1 and francium 7S1. Now coming to the group 2 elements, that is alkaline earth metals. Group 2 elements, usually called it as alkaline earth metals. You already know this. Those are, first one is beryllium, And next one is magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, and last one is radium. So we already discussed, for group 2 elements, the last electrons or valence electrons are filled by the s orbital. These all elements have a s2 orbital, 2 electrons in the valence shell. Coming to the electronic configuration of the beryllium, here atomic number is 4, so 1s2, 2s2. For magnesium, this is 12 and electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6 and 3s2. For calcium, this is 20. This you can write it as by using the inert gas configuration of argon, and the valency orbital for this is 4s2. That means the 4s orbital occupies the valency electrons. That configuration is 4s2. Coming to the strontium, this is 38. This is, you can write it as by using the electronic configuration of krypton and 5s2. And what about the barium? This is 56. By using the electronic configuration of xenon, that is 54. And the next extra 2 electrons are enters into 6s2 orbital, that is valency shell or valency orbital. And what about the radium? This is 88. That means radon has a 86 atomic number. The next 2 electrons are enters into the 7s2 orbital. This is for 87. So by using this inert gas configuration of argon, or you can say neon also you can use in the case of magnesium, krypton, xenon, radon, you can easily write the electronic configuration of the elements. Now coming to the valency electronic configuration of the group 2 elements, all are occupied by the s2, that is ns2 orbitals only. For beryllium it is 2s2, for magnesium 3s2, calcium 4s2, strontium 5s2, barium 6s2, radium 7s2. That means the group 2 elements all have a general electronic configuration or valence electronic configuration is ns2. Here n indicates the number of the period. In this case also, it is a number of period. Now you can see this in the periodic table. The left portion, this is the right portion, and this is middle one for the periodic table. Now coming to the left portion of the periodic table, these two are the group 1 and group 2 elements. This has a electronic configuration of ns1, these have a ns2. For lithium this is 2s1, sodium 3s1, potassium 4s1, and like this. This is also 2s2 for beryllium, 3s2 for magnesium, and so on. That means these all are comes under the alkali metals, and these group 2 elements are comes under the alkaline earth metals.